Hey guys, it's Frenzied. I wanted to do a quick review of some additional knives I've received recently, plus comparing them to one of my favorites, which is the Spyderco Persistence. What we've got here is a selection of pretty much what I would describe as 2 3/4 inch everyday carry blades, everyday utility blades. All these are right hovering around that distance on the blade length, and I carried each of them for a week or so. Thought I'd do a quick review on each of them. What we've got at this end is the Buck Vantage Pro with an S30V blade, and this is the, again, 2.7 inch, I think, version, the small version. And when I got this, like most of the other Buck reviews I'd seen, the blade did not center between the liners. It was actually up against the far liner here. And so I adjusted it a little by tightening it slightly. In doing so, it did affect the ability to flip it out a little bit, not a huge amount. And that's the one negative I noticed right away. But in adjusting it, it does center fairly well now. And I've carried it again for at least a week. And I tell you what, it's a very nice daily carry blade. There's, other than the alignment issue with these guys, very nice. The flipper is slightly undersized, in my opinion, due to that blade alignment length issue, or alignment issue. It would have been nice if it stuck out further so you could put a little more pressure on it, because you do have to have it tightened down to get it to line up correctly in the center. If I didn't mind it rubbing, you know, I could loosen it back up and it flipped out just fine then. But yeah, this blade, I've always kind of liked Bucks. I had them as a child, and I think that's a nice shape, actually, too, for a daily carry blade. About the perfect size for me, too. I really like that size. I like the tip-down carry. And I like the rider-left-hand ability on it, too. The clip is very nice. I probably would like it slightly better if it was a black-colored clip, so that it would blend in with my dark slacks that I generally wear. But that's okay, though. I mean, most of the other knives I carry are the same, with a satin sheen on it. Overall, pretty impressive, though. It is a $50 knife. I believe I spent about $48 on this, so not exactly cheap, but given that blade steel, that's not a bad little knife at all. Compare that to, like this guy, it is a CRKT Drifter. I'm not sure of exactly what steel it is. Knowing that it's CRKT, it's probably something like AUS6 or something, but please check online to find out for sure. But this is a very nice little knife given the price. This knife in particular, I want to say, was like $17.99, right at 18 bucks, from Amazon.com, I believe. And it's got everything you pretty much need for a nice everyday carry utility blade, something you use to open boxes and cut straps and twine and just anything you'd need. The only downside, in my opinion, would be that it does have a clip that only functions in one direction, which is right hand carry and then tip down orientation. It is a nice dark black clip, though, so it does pretty much vanish when you drop them into black blue jeans or dark slacks. It's not noticeable that you're carrying it. And it does not have a flipper, which I mentioned in another video too. I don't think it would have added much to the price for CRKT to have added a little flipper onto the, you know, tang of the blade or whatever you want to call it. I would have liked to have seen that, but I mean, that's a small thing. You can certainly use the thumb stud to flip it out very quickly if you need to. So a great little blade for given that price, $18 or so, given that it's got those couple little, I wouldn't even call them issues, but just features that are missing. What we've got here is a frame lock version of the same thing. Everything I said about this one applies to this. It's slightly heavier and feels slightly sturdier. Now, one little thing I will mea culpa to on these guys. Originally, this blade was on this knife, and this blade was on this knife. Me looking at them, I'm never afraid to dive in and start modifying things, especially when they're inexpensive. So I took these two apart and swapped the blades on them, put them back together. And the first one I carried and played with was this guy, and it works fine. No issues at all with that swap. However, the frame lock version, not until I really went to go to carry it did I notice that it will not fully lock up with this blade in it. The blade that comes in the frame lock version is slightly shorter at the bottom end. It's cut down very slightly for the frame lock to drop into. So I've got to take both these back apart and swap these blades around. I actually really like the color now the way they are. I wish I could, and I thought about going ahead and just grinding on that blade a little bit just to make it work, because the frame lock blade does work fine, perfectly in this G10 model, and you'll notice that the liner goes all the way over on it for full coverage on it, so it actually works pretty nice, and there is no up or down play or side to side play either. So very nice. I just need to get it fixed in the frame lock. I took the clip off this one. The clip color matched the frame when I took them apart, and I never remounted it because of the problem. So that's the only reason the clip's not on there. What we've got here is a CRKT Ripple 2. It's the smaller version of this knife. I saw a couple reviews on it, and they seem to kind of be good raving reviews about the knife. And I've got to say that I agree with pretty much everything I've heard about this knife. When I received this knife about 2 weeks ago, maybe Friday of last week, so over 2 weeks ago now, I started carrying it daily, and it very quickly replaced my Sage and Persistence for my just general go-to everyday blade. And I started carrying this every single day, right pocket carry. It's just a wonderful knife. It's got a very interesting feel to it. It feels both delicate because of all the intricacies of the little holes and the grooves and everything, but yet sturdy. And it also feels just wonderfully light, yet hefty. It's quite a mystery how they did it. I just love it. It feels perfect. The blade length is perfect for daily carry. I would probably like it a little bit better if it had a little wider blade and a little longer belly on it. But then again, it wouldn't be the same blade. It wouldn't be quite as delicate and nice and small. It'd be a little wider and heavier then. I love the design too, and I love the color. I am not, like I mentioned in my previous video I posted today, I'm not a tactical kind of guy. I just don't care for the scary black blades that much. If I've got a choice of any other color, orange, yellow, red, whatever, blue, I will generally go with that other color. And I do like this blue, I really do. And I will probably be buying the larger version of this. This Ripple 2 is the, like I mentioned, a 2 3/4 inch version. The one downside, the only downside I know of to this knife, or knife that I've discovered so far, is this clip. It is a very narrow clip and relatively short. And I think due to that, it shifts around in my pocket a good bit. It slides out of my pocket, the clip does, so it'll slide upward and creep while I'm walking and sitting and standing. And it is my fear that at some point I will lose this knife. It will pop out and I won't notice it. So that is a definite fear that I've got. But other than that, I love it, absolutely love it. I am in the process of ordering the 3-inch plus version of that. This is the other knife that I did order and you haven't seen a review on. It is that CRKT Full Throttle. It's a Krommer knife, Krommer, K-O-M-M-E-R, I'm not sure of the pronunciation. Interesting knife, and like I mentioned in my other video I posted today, I don't know that I would purchase it again given the choice. Again, it is just a little glitzy, a little, I don't know, gaudy is I guess maybe a better word. It's also not very functional in my opinion. It's very slippery. I do love that blade shape though. If they do offer it in some other construction material like G10 handles where it's lighter and grippier and without the gold everywhere, I can see myself getting it again, especially if it ended up with a flipper. Not a bad little blade though, other than just it's dressed up a little bit too much for me. And then the Persistence, you guys have all seen. It's a wonderful knife. Absolutely love it. But again, oh, and the price wise, this was almost $50. These were both less than $20. This was $68, I believe. And the Persistence, you guys have seen, that's $25 to $30. And then finally, the CRKT Full Throttle here was like $45 or something along that line. And it is an assisted opener. There you go. There's my review of my 2 3/4 inch knives. Thank you.